A real common problem with tri-powers, I get a lot of emails and questions about, is flooding and dripping. My tri-power's dripping all over. Sometimes it's a real major drip, sometimes minor. Let's talk about the major one first. If you have some flooding that's so bad that the car won't even run, you've probably got a float sticking or you've got fuel in a float. So you'd want to take off the air horn or the guilty carburetor. I'm assuming now that it's been running fine and all of a sudden you get this huge fuel leak. Take off your float. If you've got a brass float, shake it basically, see if there's any fuel in it. Usually there won't be, but that's something to check. Then check to make sure that the seat is tight. There's a gasket between the needle and seat, especially if you've had the carburetor apart or rebuilt recently. If you haven't tightened up the seat pretty good, it can back out just a little bit. I don't know if the gasket swells or what's happening there, but if the seat's loose, then you're going to have fuel running all the time. Even after you shut off the car, there's a little bit of pressure left. So you want to check that. So once you've eliminated, the other thing is, you could have some debris in the needle and seat. So you might want to take it out. The traditional needle and seat, you probably don't need to take out, but blow air through it just to get any debris out. You probably won't see it. It could be so small as to be almost invisible. But blow it out. With this one, you can do the same thing, blow air around the pin. Then check that it's tight, blow some air through it, check your float, check the float level, which I covered earlier, and put it back together. If you still have problems, there are a couple of areas that it could be. Very common, especially if you've just put your car together, is you have too much fuel pressure. A tri-power, or really any Rochester two-barrel, can only take about 3 to 4 pounds of fuel pressure. This is a regulator I really like. I don't have them on my webpage right now, but you might check them. I'm going to try and get them on there. Made by Mr. Gasket. Very simple. Has an in and out, and you can adjust it just by clicking, push and click. And a tri-power, I would put it at 3 to 3.5 pounds and leave it there. You can try going higher, but there's really no need. My own car, a 65 GTO, it's set at 3 pounds, turned to 12.7 in the quarter. So it's not, basically that you need to have 3 pounds when you're at full throttle at the top of second gear. You know, it's not, you don't need a tremendous lot of pressure, you just need pressure all the time. One thing nice about this one, if you really want to hide it, you could scuff it up a little, paint it blue, the same color as your motor, and put it down near the fuel filter. So. That's a big one. I really check that. The other thing that's happening more common, ethanol fuel boils at about a 20 degree lower temperature than straight gasoline. And in 2009, as I'm recording this, they're talking about changing the amount of ethanol in the fuel from 10% to 12 and then 15. So I imagine the boiling point is going to get lower and lower. So you've got heat going underneath the middle carburetor through the crossover here. So that's a pretty hot area. You can block crossover, of course, or if you have aftermarket heads, you may not have any exhaust crossover gas to deal with, but you could block the crossover. The other thing you could do is put some insulators between the carburetors and the manifold, and they look like a gasket. I've got them on the webpage. They're available in quarter inch thickness or a half inch. I'm kind of recommending to put the quarter inch is nice on the ends, but the half probably better in the middle. And I'm also comes with a kit with the longer studs. Raises your carburetor either a quarter or a half. Makes very little difference in the geometry of the linkage or anything. For the half inch one, I've got a set of choke tubes that'll fit the raised carburetor. And on the 66 tri-power with the rod, I have sell the rod with the kit that'll accommodate either the quarter inch or the half inch spacers. But yeah, heat's a big culprit because, again, the gas in your float bowl will boil, especially after you turn the car off. And it'll just seep out the side of the carburetor, drip on your manifold. And then, of course, when you go to start it, it's either flooded if you've just turned it off or if it's the next day or two. Carburetor's empty and it's going to crank quite a while before it starts. So those are the main issues with flooding. Again, fuel pressure and check your float mechanism system.